Hey guys, can you give me the IUPAC name for this compound?
No, but seriously, what I'm going to show you guys in this video is how to go from an NMR and its molecule's chemical formula to its structure. Yeah, I know this isn't a chemical, but I forgot my model kit. And it works better this way, so I don't give away the answer. But yeah, this is the hardest part for NMRs. Hopefully I could simplify it down a little bit for you guys, okay? Okay, so the first step in trying to solve this NMR puzzle, right, is to figure out degrees of unsaturation. Why do we want to figure this out? Well, if you figure out that your molecule has 1 degree of unsaturation, right, that means that for sure there's a double bond in there. If it has 2, then it could either be a triple bond, 2 double bonds, or your molecule might have a cyclic ring structure. Hey guys, sorry, I just realized I made a little mistake, so I'm going to try and clear it up, okay? So basically, a cyclic ring will cause 1 degree of unsaturation, just like a double bond. So what I was trying to say is that if your molecule has 1 degree of unsaturation, then there must be either a double bond in it or a cyclic ring. But once you get to 2 degrees of unsaturation or higher, then that opens up a lot of possibilities, right? Because you can either have a triple bond in the structure, or a double bond and a cyclic ring, or 2 double bonds or 2 cyclic rings, because they all add up to 2 degrees of unsaturation, right? Okay, sit back, relax, enjoy the rest. But either way, if you figure this out, it'll give you a little bit more information on your molecule, and that'll be very, very helpful when you actually have to draw your molecule out. Okay, so the equation for degrees of unsaturation is 2 times the number of carbons in your molecule plus 2. I don't know why 2, but plus n, which is the number of nitrogens, minus x, the number of halides, which are basically fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, minus the number of hydrogens divided by 2. Nice and simple, okay? So try that out, come back, and let's see if we get the same answer. No. Okay, well, I got 1 degree of unsaturation. Did you get that too? If you did, nice job. But let me, in case you got it wrong, let me just walk you through it. 2 times the number of carbons is, so 4 gives me 8, right? Plus 2, because that's just in the equation, that gives me 10 minus 8. For the 8 hydrogens in my chemical formula, it gives me 2. There were no nitrogens and no halides, so that's why 0 and 0. And 2 divided by 2 is equal to 1. Okay? The next step now, we found out that there's 1 degree of unsaturation, so that means that our molecule must have a double bond. Okay? Next step will be integration. So the next part to figure out... So the next part to figuring out this NMR puzzle is to do integration. Because when you try to do a puzzle, right, you need to find all your puzzle pieces and put them together. Well, now we're going to get our puzzle pieces. And what I mean is that by doing integration, you can figure out how many hydrogens are represented by each peak. Okay? If you watch my video part 3 of the series, you should know that this peak will for sure have the most hydrogens because the doublet is so much taller than the other two. But when you do integration, right, basically you need to find your baseline. And what I mean by that is right here. If you have to do integration on a test, you'll have a line that's sort of like this one that runs through all your peaks. And you start at your baseline over here. And as your baseline goes through the peaks, right, it detects more and more hydrogens. And as a result, the baseline is going to go up, up, and up. So if you take a look at our purple line over here, that's also telling us that this peak over here, or this doublet over here, has the most hydrogen since it has the greatest change from baseline. Okay, so why don't we set this to 0? All right, so baseline is 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, set that to 0. And then you basically figure out how high up your baseline increases. So it increased by 1, 2, 3, 4. All right. And then we use this equation over here. The number of hydrogens divided by the rise in lines, or basically the increase from baseline. The most common mistake that people make is that they start from here, thinking that this is the baseline, so don't do that. All right. So the number of hydrogens that we know from our chemical formula, is 8, and then divided by the rise in lines, or I guess the number of lines actually in our molecule, it's basically 4, right? So that basically tells us that in our NMR, we have 2 hydrogens represented by each line, right? So next step is you come over to your NMR, and you basically figure out how the baseline has changed at each peak. So at this one over here, right, we started off at basically, let's say zero, and we went up by one half of a line. So one half of a line is going to be one hydrogen, because two hydrogens is if your line goes up by one. So one hydrogen over here, and then as you go across, nothing really changes. But once you get to the septet over here, right, it goes up by another half a line. So if it goes up by half a line, we know from integration, a half a line is basically just one hydrogen. And then at the doublet, we went up from one, right? We went one, two, three, so three lines, and three lines means six hydrogens. Okay, and that's basically it for integration, okay? The next part, we're just gonna make our awesome table so we can get everything nice and organized and get our puzzle pieces organized so we can actually piece everything together and get the structure of our molecule. All right, awesome table time. What we're basically gonna do now is, if we were continuing my analogy about the NMR puzzle, we're basically gonna organize our puzzle pieces so this way we can see everything better. Because when you're doing an actual puzzle, right, you wanna put all the border pieces on the side, so this way you can do them first and then the middle pieces. And we're basically gonna do that for NMR right now. So for our awesome table, right, we have three columns, the shifts at which the signals appear, the number of hydrogens that they actually represent, which we already did with integration. So see, that was really helpful. And then we need to figure out the number of hydrogens that are pissing off these hydrogens and causing them to split, like our septet over here and our doublet over here. Okay? So yeah, give that a shot and come back in a couple seconds, and we're gonna finally piece this sucker over here all together.